Okay, Sheriff's Office, I understand that Sergeant Morgan has retired, so we...
Correct.
So we have a new sergeant in town, Robert Copley.
The new sheriff in town.
New sheriff.
I'll have new prepared, but they don't need it. Yeah, Jim Morgan kind of all of a sudden got another offer, so he decided to dump a dip and retire. And he's now working for Safari Dan, which is emergency rescue gear company. And we've got a really good position with them, so we can't blame him for leaving after 27 years. So I'm Robert Copley. I've been assigned from Victor Valley to Phelan. And actually, had been wanting this station for the past 10 years or so. Just had to wait for somebody to...
Do you live out here?
Yes.
Okay, great.
Yeah. Real quickly about me, I've been on 23 years. I'm due to retire in August, however, I'm going to...
Wait a minute.
I want his job next, so I...
Jim told me, he says, well, after being at Phelan, you'll want to retire in August, but because it is very... It is really a very demanding position that we're put in, especially at the sergeant level. So I'm going to try to take it on. I'm going to give him probably 3 more years as a result of that. So we'll see what happens. But my forte with the department has been child abuse and homicides involving children and internet predators and all that kind of thing. I did all that for 5 years, so I've seen the worst of the worst when it comes to that. Fortunately, not a whole lot of bad stuff out here. Real quickly on the crime, though, the past month we had 2 auto theft rings we broke up here in the tri-community area, specifically Phelan. One of them was right at the corner of Phelan and Johnson Road, right in front of us, behind chain link fence, and a helicopter was flying over, picked up a low jack signal, flew around. I have low jack in my car, so between the two of us, we kind of zeroed in on this house, and we got our SANCAT team up, which is the grant for the auto theft task force, and we door knocked this house, and we ended up finding the vehicle that was putting off the low jack signal was stolen in West Hollywood the same morning. We recovered 6 more Toyota pickups in that same backyard. 2 days ago, over at Wilson Ranch and Smoke Creek, somewhere in that general area, we got in a pursuit of a vehicle. The guy's foot bailed. We recovered that vehicle. It was a stolen. We ID'd some information that was inside that truck. Took us to a house, and we recovered more stolen vehicles. We got 6 more people in custody.
Right.
So we're working on that. Actually, the last 2 months have been very, very good results with that. But also, again, if you remember a few months ago, we had the daytime door kick. Jimmy had talked about the guy on the little quad he fought, or the three-wheeler. We got him. Well, now somebody else is doing the same thing. Now they're in the Oak Hills, Baldy Mesa area. And we got into a pursuit yesterday with a small red pickup truck, either a Ford F-150 or an S-10. We lost the guy. The crooks usually have a lot more reason to run than we do to have to catch them sometime. You know, we're not going to crash a $50,000 car.
Right.
Always. Depends why we're chasing them. But at any rate, a small red pickup is what we're looking for. There's a white male. We have some information. We think we know who it is. And the guy's a weekender for doing the last door case. So we're working on that. Phelan Station is up to full staffing right now, full manpower, the first time in a long time. We're up to 9, which is a good compliment for this area. What I'm going to do is re-implement problem-oriented policing. Anybody know what that is? Basically, the sheriff has a strong belief in this program. Unfortunately, because of manpower, we can't always institute it or keep it up and running. I'm going to give it a shot here again in Phelan and see if we can manage it. Basically, what this does is I take the 9 deputies we have, and they're each assigned a specific area for the tri-community. The deputies are responsible for what goes on in their quadrant. Now, unfortunately, I can't assign them a beat to work that beat every time they're on shift because we just have to move around too much. But we're going to make them responsible for that area. And what this does, that deputy focuses in on his area, which might be one of our beats, actually 12 of our beats each. And if he sees a home that is, we're going to have to set the standard a little different, but way below a standard, and they have code enforcement problems going on, they have trash, they have junk cars, they have a lot of the stuff we see Why are they cluttering up our neighborhood? If we get complaints on too much traffic, possibly some criminal activity going on, the deputy's gonna take that project on. And by using the other resources throughout the county, we're gonna make that house or that business or that area a project and try to clean it up. We're also gonna be keeping a better eye out for graffiti or vandalism, vehicle abatement on public property, and if time permits, abandoned homes that pose a public threat or hazard. And that's a whole different issue. But actually, when I worked out in Barstow, we were quite successful in the Hinkley area to get that cleaned up. What I brought along with me is a crime analysis map. Anybody ever seen one? Anybody want to see one?
Sure.
Okay. Yeah. This is the good part. I was looking for a zip tie on these things. I thought they're handle. I'll push it towards you. There it is. Okay. All right. Okay, this map is for last March. Now, this is the whole area that our station, I'm sorry, the Victor Valley Station serves. Okay, this is Phelan over here. This is Phelan, Pinon Hills, Wrightwood. Each one of these little keys are decoded down here. It tells you what kind of and how many of these different crimes are out here. A lot of these, the GTA or auto theft, as a result of that auto theft theory, that we broke up. You can see the big area right now, home burglaries, and this is right up in the west area of Oak Hills, which is the extreme south end of Baldy Mason. This is where we get our daytime door kicks, Grand Theft Auto here and here. We had, and that's a new code, residential robbery, like a home invasion type. Don't let that alarm you, because that is not a random crime. Usually that's drug related. Somebody knows somebody and let's go get our money back type thing. So that's not like, it's a real problem. And then last week we had, I believe the fire department mentioned the gunshot, suicide. Yeah. And that's the only thing we had here regarding the fatal. And then all the rest of these were solved batteries, thefts, concentrated right in the downtown area. All in all, the big picture is that it's on the decline. It's looking really good. This map may look alarming, but actually, it's very positive. Neighborhood Watch also trails with the problem-oriented policing. And I don't know what the Neighborhood Watch situation is here right now. If there is one, if it's even up and going, I'm still kind of going through the station and seeing what needs to be done. But that would be me.
Okay, well, because
in touch with me.
My friend lives right around the corner, and she would like to start a Neighborhood Watch in her little small area there.
Our response times are getting better and quickly on that. We have to take our calls in order of priority, which is like triage in a hospital.
Yes.
And some people get upset because they may see state borders in the road or even a vandalism or tagging going on. And unfortunately, we're busy on that assault and battery or burglary or something else more important that's going on. So all the calls are important. We just have to take them in a priority. So it seems sometimes like a call will be holding for a couple of hours, maybe even a burglary. That's because there's something at the time, crimes against people come before crimes against property. But I have noticed the response times have increased a whole lot during the year.
The response time has decreased, you mean?
Response times are getting better.
I was a little tired there.
The reason is,